Okay, I'm just going to do this landing. Sorry about the twin view. I'm just going to do this landing. I'll let you look at the settings that I'm running on this 1080 Ti. That's quite shocking, really. In a good way. So I've just done the Crin Canal. Not that you'll be able to see it. So that's I've gone east coast to west coast, following the Crin and the locks straight across Scotland. So we're just coming out now into the estuary on the west coast, and I'm looking for the airport on the left hand side. And I'm just going to land it. For those of you who don't know, the Crin Canal is basically a way of getting
Alpha
from,
Delta uniform wind tree 21 and 20.
Getting from
clear
one
Delta
side.
Runway 2-3.
Oh, shut up. Right. Getting from one side of Scotland to the other side of Scotland in a boat without having to go right round the top.
Clear to land runway 23, says the Alpha Delta uniform.
So, as you can see, lots of trees, all very clear, no stuttering, all the bells are on, I can read all of them. So somewhere on my left is a runway that is running east to west. I've not landed here before. I've not got my mouse, quite windy here, I think. Bit of turbulence, what we're running at. We're running at 1600 feet. It's not up there, but it's in a natural bay, so it could be down there or just over that next hill. I've got the live weather on, I've got live aircraft on as well. Set at 100. So if there's anything out there, it's up there. Certainly won't be down here where I am. I've got quite a number of things set on ultra, believe it or not. And I'm running the 1080 Ti and a old Oculus CV1. Sorry, you spot things and you just go, oh, I wonder what that's. Forget, I'm supposed to be talking. Okay, so one way of spotting what your frame rate's like is look out at the edge of your wing. Just peer a bit and see if there's any major stuttering. Oh, so this central bar here, it all starts going jaggy. You're pushing it too far. Central spar. Okay, I've got a feeling it's just over that hill, but I'm not seeing, there is a bit of a crosswind here, so I was all the way across the country, so I've kind of been flying at a jaunty angle, and I'm not seeing it down here. There's got to be a natural bay just over this hill, and the runway is going to be there. Which we will see as we pop over the top. We're not massively high, we're coming up on 2800 feet. I'll just drop the rev slightly. I'm getting a bit of a lift got the clouds on medium. I've got light shafts on as well. Forgot on shadows, ground shadows on, just to add a bit more to the visuals. As we come out into to the big bay, North Sea right in front of us out there in the distance. So I've got some natural bays here on the left, which are looking good. Just clear this hill here. As you can see, I'm actually flying in that direction, not that direction, because of the crosswind. It's just been messing with me all the way through. Waves and water is up at medium as well. It is a grey day, so you're just getting a reflection of a grey sky into it all in a bit. Naff, right, so it's supposed to be opposite this little island that's sitting out in the middle here. So it's definitely off here. Now, is it the first bay or the second bay? I should be able to spot it, to be honest. Just come across over to the left, just in case it's in this first bay. I think it's in the second one. So 1900 feet, just so we can clear the tops of these hills coming in. It's quite a square bay. Don't think it's here. If it is here, it's that white area over there. It doesn't look like it's big enough. So it's got to be that second bay. So as you can see, as I'm looking straight down, it's all. I'm getting a bit of bouncing. From the wind, not from the graphics. Go smooth as you like. A bit of a town tucked behind the hill there. Oh, something's gone on. Yeah. Sink rate's just gone through the floor. So I think this is the bay here in front of me. So it's on the south edge of it, on the left. Sky, sun is just starting to pop through. Have you seen anything kind of flickering in front of me? That's the actual prop, not fake, going across weird in 2D world. This runway. Should start to see it in a bit. Unless it's that next estuary. Don't think it is. I could be wrong. Just clear the top of this hill. Have a look. Lost about 500 feet through that turn. Drop in the coming over the hill. Now we're starting to get lift again now off this next hill. So no, I don't think this is bay, but we're running out of that island. Gotta be the next one because I'm out of island. way. So that's it down there. See it there where the river comes out. Yeah, so I'll just have a little bit of a look at it and I'll come round from the other side. Yeah, that's definitely the wrong way. That's definitely my dog. That's the other dog. Okay, so we've got a bit of a caravan park at the end of the runway. Nice. You can see that just down there. So yeah, we're coming from the other side of the river there. Altitude is coming down on 1200 feet.
That's the end of the runway.
A bit of a tight turn on it. Oh, bridge going over the river there. Just widen this turn up a bit. Shadows are looking good. Okay, and as we straighten it up, we will drop a little bit of flaps in. Turbulence coming off that hill in front of me because the wind is quite high today for this part of the world. Oops, as you can probably see, yeah, there's a turbulence, it's dropping everywhere, it's not my airspeed. Airspeed is fine. So yeah, coming in on a crosswind, gently pull it down. Whoa, that went a bit deep tongue. Back up with these guys. So yeah, even on the ground it's all looking good, but some of these planes here in the airport, it's crashing to a horrible frame rate or anything. Stick it between these two. That'll do. Turn it off and I'll show the settings. Off, off, fuel, off. Right, what I'll do is I'll come back into some old 2D land. Back to main menu. That's a 52-hour flight. Right, main menu. Turn that off. See you again now. So we just go to settings, you'll get an idea what I'm running on here. Excuse that, my monitor's just, I'm just changing cables around, so I'm running a medical monitor, quite a bit of a weird resolution. So render scaling, that's the big one, 100%. In fact, film VR. Yeah, render scaling 100%. Anti-aliasing is top one TAA. Terrain level of detail, it's just basically log. How far things get drawn in, I put it 50. Same at objects level of detail, 50. Off-screen terrain pre-caching, ultra. Terrain vector data, ultra. Buildings run low. Trees run high. Grass and bushes are off. Volumetric clouds, medium. Temperature resolution, ultra. Anisotropic filtering times 2, texture supersampling times 2, texture temperatures high, water and waves medium. That's the shadow maps 768 and 128. Contact shadows are off, windshield effects ultra, which is brilliant for the rain. Ambient occlusion off, cube map reflections on 128, grey match reflections on RTX, sorry, they're off. Light shafts on medium. Does add a lot with the clouds. Bloom off, cockpit refresh rate low. Right, and that's that. Oh, and just for the other stuff, was running. Traffic was at 100%. Traffic was 100%. Also, everything was on, background, multiplayer. So live weather, real world air traffic, photogrammetry, Bing data world graphics, and online functionality. Right, okay, I'll leave it there because that's gone on a bit too long. Because